And we're here with the last match of this best of three in the show match between Burden, United and Power Rangers. The winner of this match will go home with €500. The loser will sadly get nothing. And I want to remind everybody, this is organized by Electronic Sports Against Addictions. This is a non-profit organization that's trying to help out people with addictions here, trying to inform everybody. And guys, they're just doing this for a good cause. So please go to their website, esportsagainstaddiction.com, and help them out, support them, follow this channel, make sure to watch everything and just help them out. And guys, well, that was that for that. We're going to go back into the match now. Third match of our show match here. One versus one, Power Rangers won the first. The second game was won by Burden United. We're the casters from Swiss DC. I'm Sander, with me is Zach. Let's go, let's do it. Let's go for it.
Let's do it, man. This is game three. I didn't expect it to go to game three. Power Rangers were asserting their dominance in game one, but Burden United came straight out the gates. Boom, boom. That Wisp Tiny was very potent. Definitely won the game for them there. As well as the Witch Doctor. Maumee. Yeah. Yeah, he was playing amazing on that Witch Doctor, got the early Aghanim Scepter to pick up, and it just escalated from there. Now let's have a look at the draft.
Yeah, let's go into there. And now, well, Power Rangers, I think they learned something from last game. Don't give Nii his IO.
Yeah, especially in the first game, that mid-Wisp did some work in the early game, but Jackal coming back with that anti-mage.
Yeah, they didn't really have something to combo up with it. I think that was a problem. I don't even think that was that bad of an idea to put Nii's Mist. He was wrecking face, but just didn't have the real thing to combo it up with. Like, you have an Enchantress, okay, that's nice, but it's just not a je ne sais quoi. It's not what you want. It's not the big damage that you can get out of there. And with that IO Tiny combination in game 2, they did.
Yeah, we've been seeing Tusk banned out every game so far. What's your opinion on Tusk in his current meta? Like, I've been seeing him a little bit played by Team Secret and other teams like that. So what's your opinion on the old...
At the moment, Tusk is being picked up over all the scenes. European, SEA, China, it doesn't matter. He gets picked up everywhere. He's just this strong hero that you're so diverse with. You're able to do so many things. You can offlane him or you can just run him as a support. This is already making the other people think, like, have we been out supports? Do we need to ban out offlaners? Well, it's just a really easy way to initiate into a fight with the snowball. There's no really need for an item on top of that. Shorts are just able to keep out the enemy team or keep your own team. You know, keep them close to your own team. It's so much utility in that. And the Sejo is just so incredibly annoying to deal with. Slowing down, attack speed goes down. And then you have an ultimate that goes through BKB. It just has so much utility in this hero. It's always so the save with the snowball can be big, really, really big. In the beginning, actually, once the snowball was reworked, they actually picked Tusk as a counter versus Faceless Void. And once he pops his chrono, he just goes next to it with a blink, pops his snowball and gets the people out of the Faceless Void chrono. That was so fun to see. Yeah, that was really fun to see. Didn't always work, though. Yeah, I think at the moment it's just a great hero and so much utility in it. And Burden United seems to be thinking the same since they picked it up here. They pick it up together with the Earthshaker. Another good zoning hero as well with the Fissure, just keeping out people in or out. So it's kind of like the Tusk but Earthshaker combination here. It's just a good zoning heroes as well as actually the initiation for Earthshaker just comes a whole of a lot easier with the snowball.
Yeah, Tusk is just very diverse, as you've said, and really sets up the Earthshaker Enchant Totem as well. That's nothing to... Gyrocopter, hey? Yeah, Gyrocopter, very popular pick and ban, I think. Just the diversity as well on him, as he can be mid. He's one carry that can go in defensive tri-lane as well as an aggro tri-lane. And scales really well in the late game. And the early game magic damage is so good against heroes like Wyvern. And then the late game physical damage really counters the clockwork too. 10 seconds remaining.
Indeed, it is just such a strong hero there. And it does reveal a little bit more about the draft here though. I don't think they're going to be... They might still be running Tusk support though. So. I don't think you don't really run a Tusk and a Gyrocopter support combination here. And... They might actually be doing that because last game Bignum was the one playing the Undying and easy offlaner for Burden here. So we're gonna see actually a Tusk support. Most likely here with the Undying. Okay. Power Rangers, they pick up the Juggernaut. Nice here, well, good versus all the magical damage coming out from here as well as just having the Omni Slash to get out of a little bit. Well, dangerous situations, let's say like that, and it just really has its benefits. And well, chat, I don't think we're gonna see techies this game though. 5 seconds remaining. It would be fun. What do you think?
I wanna
maybe
see techies.
For Burden, you know, see the Tusk techies combination showcased by Secret before. It would be fun. Yeah, Power Rangers, what are they going to be looking at? They still need another support. They still need another mid player here. What do you think they're going to be picking up next?
Sorry, I just muted myself. They're probably looking for a mid right now for Ditch RR. I really am. A couple mids have been banned out right now, all the popular ones, and TA coming out here.
Yeah, that's an hero that has been on the rise lately as well. You have been seeing more and more of him.
Oh yeah, and definitely Ditch RR playing the TA as well. I've seen him play a little bit of that recently, with Sunlight's absence in the team. 10 seconds remaining. And Burden United, they're probably looking for a second support here. And they have a predominantly melee lineup.
I think Burden is actually looking for mid laner as well. I don't think they're looking for support. Like, you can run Tusk and Earthshaker as supports, Earthshaker and Dying as supports, Tusk and Dying as supports. They have enough options as supports. They need something extra here. Because just the Gyrocopter versus the TA and Juggernaut in late game is going to be tough. Even if one of three heroes is going to be a core, they're not able to withstand versus those heroes. I do want to say TA is going to have a good, okay-ish game until Gyrocopter gets close to her. That's kind of a problem with the Rocket Barrage. It will get Reflection charges off really, really fast. In the other way, it also means that he's able to block a lot of the Rocket Barrage damages as well. 5 seconds remaining. Invoker. And yeah, there you go, Burden United. They pick up an Invoker here. Are we gonna see some immortal gaming here with the Gyrocopter and Invoker just having new immortals?
Yeah. I reckon it'd be quite cool to see.
It's gonna be fun to see. I want to see it. Those new Invoker orbs are really, really cool. And the Gyrocopter Rocket Barrage sounds like Tinker's Laser times 100. So fun. 10 seconds remaining.
Okay. The Power Rangers need their second support, and we got Keeper.
So Juggernaut, he's gonna have a good time with getting mana all the time here, able to just keep on spinning around, as well as for the Winter Wyvern, and for himself a little bit as well. You know, keep the Eliminating Blast going all the time.
Yeah. This is definitely going to be an interesting game, and yeah, this is a strong draft coming out from Burden United. I am liking their draft a lot more here than Power Rangers' draft.
They just have a lot more control. Like, for Power Rangers, the real control that they have comes from the Clockwork and the Winter Wyvern, well, from Burden. It's the Tusk, Earthshaker plus Invoker, and Gyrocopter even has abilities to zone and keep people away as well. So it's just a lot more control there. And just if a totem gets put down, called on top of it, and you're stuck in it, they just throw up an easy wax, maybe even a meteor or anything along those lines to kill them off.
Yeah.
Time for preparations. Well, this is gonna be a great match here.
Yeah, so I've introduced PR.
Sure, go ahead.
Yeah, we have Gorek on the Cottle, Cheshire Cat on the Clockwork. We have Jackal playing the Juggernaut, J4 on the Winter Wyvern. There's a change, Gorek was on the Winter Wyvern before. And we have Ditch RR on the Templar Assassin.
Indeed, and here for Burnley United, we have Come With Me playing the Gyrocopter. In middle, we're going to see Mind Control playing the Invoker, rocking the Super Saiyan here. Do we actually have the Immortal here on the Gyrocopter? Let's take a quick look. No, he doesn't. Okay, that is a bad job by him. He needs to get one, guys. Someone gifted. And Dusk is going to be played by Nihis here. Big Num is going to be playing Undying, and that leaves Maomi to be playing the Earthshaker here.
Yeah, we just have a quick pause there. We see Power Rangers moving towards the top rune as well as Burden United. What do you think is going to go on here? Big, massive fight on the top rune?
Well, essentially, I think Burden United would be able to get it. You can just, if they're not there on time, you can quite easily zone them all out with the Fissure.
Uh-oh, Cheshire Cat. Definitely living life on the edge here.
Going With Me, he's parading around. He wants to see him and he might be able to see him soon. But Cheshire Cat is able to walk away just in time. He's going to go behind Nihis as well as Mind Control here. He sees him. Oh, they see each other. Oh, this is a little bit of a weird and awkward fight here. There's going to be the... Oh, Mind Control is actually going to get locked down here quite hard by the barrier assault. Nihis has to start tanking a little bit, but he won't. He just goes for the rune. He just leaves him like, nah, I don't want to die as well. I'll take the rune.
Oh, Big Num. Oh, okay, you just got three decay stacks off the side of Power Rangers there. Practically just giving him a free salve.
He just has five stacks at the moment.
Yeah, he just got a two...
A three-man stack.
Got one three-man and then he got a two-man as well.
Man, that's a lot.
Yeah, that was a really good positioning of the decay.
Yeah, and now he just sees Jekyll. He knows he doesn't have enough mana to spin here and just... starts laying some damage in him. Jekyll will be able to survive through it though. And maybe the supports need to come in and keep Big Num away from here. They might just get another couple of DKs on top of them though. Big Num, he has the totem now. If he tries to do something here, he also has another mango if he wants to do something.
Yeah. I think here that the off lane, I think Cheshire Cat's going to have a good time here. Like, he's not going to get too zoned out by the Tusk, but on the top lane here, we have Big Num interrupting the stack and pull here.
Yeah, he's just going to take the creep wave back to his own tower, but he seems to have failed in this as the creeps go back to the heavy camp. He might just have to stand on the low ground here to release the experience. As he will. Oh, Gorik is just keeping him away. He doesn't even want to get him there. He's not going to allow him. And how is actually the Super Saiyan Invoker here doing in mid? At the moment, he's getting quite out CS'd by Dirty Raw. 11-4. And he's fairly low on HP as well. He needs to look out. If Dirty Raw can get up some hits on him, it might just be good.
On the top lane, Big Num's in trouble. And he goes down. That's a second kill for Power Rangers. Just a combination of the Arctic Burn, the Illuminate, as well as the Blade Fury coming out from Jekyll. Big Num goes down there.
Let's see him. We're gonna have a. I'm gonna think this is gonna be an Exhort Quas build.
Yeah, and the hits out now on Cheshire Cat.
Oh?
Yeah, just trading some hits and a battery assault there.
Well, I just want to talk a little bit about the Exhort Quas build on Mind Control if we have some time here before they all go after him. Do you think it's a good choice here, or should he maybe opt for the Quas Wax build instead?
Well, I think the aim of the game here with the Exhort Quas was to... Oh, here we go. We have a go mid. Never mind here.
Oh, there's going to be the Sunstrike. It looks beautiful, but it does no damage to the Refraction of Dirty
No.
as he gets a solo kill here.
I think that the Cold Snap as well as the Forest Fritz could really eat through the Refraction charges. And unlike the Coswex, you only really are dependent on the Cold Snap. So I think it is the preferred build against the TA. And the Squishies on the side of PR as well, the Sunstrike can really help out.
Indeed, and something that we actually forgot to mention here, I just remembered. TA also got an Immortal here, and Dirty Raw is rocking that one.
Oh yeah, the beautiful gold blades, they're lovely.
They're really, really big though.
Oh yeah. Here we go again, Mind Control, he's overextended. Ditcher Raz is going to give him a few punches in the face, but Mind Control brought us out this time.
Well, here on top, they're still just all fighting around this hard camp all the time. Big Num, he just throws out the totem. He wants to go for J4. He does have the Arctic Burn to just fly over the cliff here.
And Jackal's just free farming quite happily, and so is mind control. Come with me, sorry, on the bot lane. He's just loving it there.
He does get all these creeps behind through him now, so that hurts quite a lot. He does have a solve if he needs to do up there. He has a Aquila as well.
And Dichiara is a whole level higher than
and he gets block off. This is just the zoning abilities from a from an ice shard.
And nice play coming out there on Dichiara, so I think he's going to make a go on mid. He's maxing the refraction, which is I've seen quite a lot recently in some of the games where TA's been picked.
Yeah, it's just a preferred build going 3-1-1. Just have one point in melt if you need to either hide, escape, or just apply the extra damage and the armor debuff. And one blow point in Psyblade just to have, you know, the knockback towards the enemy. Get some lane control.
Yeah, I think oh god, come with me on the bot lane, just destroy a Cheshire Cat. Come with me, only barely escaping with his life. Okay. Oh, on the bot lane. He's been spotted out. Blade Fury coming in right now.
But he just snowballs all the way back to his tower.
Yeah, that's just wasting some mana on Jackal right now. He barely got any damage into the Tusk whatsoever. Recently, I've been seeing a lot of Templar Assassins. They've just been picking up the straight Desolator.
Yeah, like, that has been...
Face boost Deso.
Yeah,
what's your opinion on that?
Well, it just bursts down the enemy. Like, an Invoker is not able to really withstand against that. Earthshaker, neither. It's just so strong in terms of burst. But the one thing that it does leave you, instead of, let's just see, a Blink Dagger first, or maybe BKB or anything along those lines, is that you lack a lot of stats and HP and just survivability through mobility. But it's so potent, and with the reduced cost on the Desolator, it's certainly a pretty viable option, and it might just go for it in this game as well.
Yeah,
they're setting up for a gank here in mid.
I think that Charles wise to it. I think he can.
If he stays forwards, if he stays back, he should be fine.
Yeah, it's nighttime now, so they can't. He can't see the Earthshaker. He's popped the refraction. He's.
He's going aggressive for before it, and they're gonna be the snowball on top of him. There's gonna be the Sunstrike as well, but he has the refraction up. He's gonna get a kill on Mind Control here before they can even turn this one around.
He's gonna go for more.
There's a Melstrike, another big damage bird. Is he gonna get Naomi in time? No, Naomi is gonna survive here. He's gonna get the refraction up. Neus is gonna chase him down. Are they actually able to kill him? Bullet charges are here. Oh no, the shards. They push him to the other side. He gets away with murder.
He does indeed. Mind Control, he is not having a fun time at all. First blood just down here. Definitely setting back against the TA, and Dichara is snowballing out of control. And no doubt he's going to start stacking up the Ancients and taking them out with the Psyblades.
Oh man, it's just really showcasing the strength there of the TA.
Oh, and those glittery blades as well. They look really gorgeous. Props to Valve there.
There's actually a DD here on Come With Me, so I think Cheshire Cat might want to look out a little bit here. Oh, actually, Come With Me pops down a ward. He knows Cheshire Cat is there. Yeah, he's just going to throw a level 1 rocket on top of him here.
I think it's just a zone. He's got a full bottle as well.
Yeah. He got a full bottle with a DD again. So. And well, actually, we get a kill here on Gorak. The snowball is there, and it goes snowball into nothing. Well, actually, into an Omnislash from Jackal here. They start hitting away on the totem here, but they say no. There's going to be the Sorb keeping it alive. Jackal taking a lot of damage. The totem is destroyed, but will Jackal survive through this? He gets the healing ward out, and he will. They will try to turn this one around now. Naomi, he doesn't have his Fissure just yet. I don't think PR should follow this one down.
No. And here we go, as I was saying, Dichiravaz is going to stack some agents right now.
Yeah, just prepare them for later here. We'll soon see what this build's going to be. Oh, Come With Me finds Dirjira, or does Dirjira finds Come With Me? At the moment, they just part ways.
Yeah. I think that TA, this is TA's time in the game. Round about 10 minutes in to about 30 minutes in, I think that's when TA is very strong indeed.
Oh, they actually got a kill on top here again. Now
here we go, we have a good shot bottom.
Oh, there's gonna be the call down. They do get return kill though. With a 1-for-1 trade, Snowball comes in after Gorok. Is he able to hit him there? Yes, he is. He gets also the shards. Oh, there's going to be a TP in. And that means Nihis has to back off. Well, the TP got stopped.
Yeah, he cancelled his TP. He realized that he didn't have to go down there. He really needs a 6J4.
Man, Minecraft was just not able to do that much. He even built up a pendant as well as a Basilius here just to get some more armor and some damage and some HP to lane against this TA, but it's not really working out right now.
Who's he recalling right now?
It's 53 less hits on Dirty Rust River there, and 26 on Mind Control.
Dirty Rust dominated. Cheshire Cat spotted out.
Maomi, battery assault used. And he's just gonna run him down and just try to cox him in the end, but there's gonna be the Gold Snap on top of him, and Cheshire Cat, he's blocked off here. He's kind of stuck in the enemy jungle for now until the Fissure disappears. He just throws down a ward, waits for the Fissure, and then he would just walk away. Well, come with me, he's just laying in some damage here on the bot tier 1 tower. TP comes in, cooldown used. Oh, yeah, TP cancelled. That's something he wants to go and fight in.
Oh no, here's the Chara.
He finds Come With Me, or just Come With Me found by PR here. J4 also comes in, Arting Bird is used. Yeah, Rocket Burn's doing some damage here, but not even close to killing off anybody.
Yeah, that's 400 gold going in the way of PR there. They found out the Earthshaker as well.
Oh, Big Gnome on top though. Is he going to get... Oh, Dirt Rock gets another kill, but Big Gnome, is he going to get Omnislayer? No, Jekyll thinks the better of it and walks back.
Dakko has 625 health. He's really taking these decays like a man right now. Uh-oh. Okay, Dakko's really playing this smart. He's using the decay like... But Bignum is overestimating his own strength. When the decay stack goes, Dakko's throwing in that bit of harass, just making sure that he maximizes the damage output that he's doing against Bignum, which is really good. Let me just see Gorek now, just walking around on his lovely white horse, doing absolutely nothing.
He's just standing there, you know, close to Dirty Rust, if something happens.
He's stuck in their jungle, I don't know why.
Oh. Hmm.
Oh, he tried to, but Nihir's coming in.
What do you think is Mind Control actually going to go for? What, Hookshot?
No. Yeah, yes, Hookshot up.
Mind Control, what do you think his build is going to be now in terms of items, of course.
I reckon Butcher Trap on Necronomicon.
Oh, he is? Yeah, he's gonna get found here. He can snowball if he can get it off. And he's just waiting all this time. He gets up the sigil. Yeah, there we go. Now he finally does it. Dirty Rust also coming in. This is gonna be a dead Dusk. Here we go. Mel Strike obliterated. Mega Kill Streak already up on Dirty Rust here.
Oh, yeah, and he's not too far off the Desolator at all. Wait. Okay, he's just got the bottle of the curry. I thought he had it up already. He's only 400 gold away right now, and I think if he gets the last day on this tower, he wouldn't be too far off at all.
Oh, that's right, he's going for
it. Oh! So close by Cheshire Cat. He put the rocket flare top. If it was only max level, Big Gnome would have died then. That was really unlucky for Cheshire Cat.
But now in a quick succession, PR gets two towers, one of them was on top, it was denied though.
That's Desolator up on TA, he has enough.
That's 12 minutes Desolator if he uses two purchases. He might just do it as well, it's a little bit too early to get a BKB at 12 minutes.
There's a 15 second cooldown on the Blink of Mind Control and he's up here alone. Three PR heroes coming up here, they're closing in on him, they're looking around right now.
But they're not looking in the correct places. He can TP out in 4 seconds, he is able to make this. They're not going to find him in time here.
He's still hanging around.
Oh, they're going to turn this one around. They're going to try and do a turn around here. Dirty Rust, he's still looking. Oh, he might just find him. he's got what? He didn't see Microtool there? Okay, he sees him now. He gets up the refraction, melt on top of him as well. Microtool taking a lot of damage here. He's going to go down. Yes, he will.
He should have got out. Oh, here we go now.
Oh, Winter's Curse on Big Gnome. Taking a lot of damage. Soul Reap's keeping him alive a little bit longer, but there's going to be the Blast on top of him. He's going to take a fall. 2-0 right now. Going with me. He's turning this one around. Dirty Rust is going to take a fall here. And there is going to be the Blinding Light putting Nihis in underneath the tower here. Well, going with me. He's just doing his damage with the Rocket Barrage here. Getting another kill for the Undying in this case. And now J4. He's going to get a kill on Nihis here. 3-2 trade. PR still ahead. Well, oh, go with me. He's not done. He just runs in here. He wants Jekyll. Jekyll is spinning, but there's not enough versus the Rat Pixel.
He's gonna get me.
He just keeps on going. Another rocket barrage, and he gets another kill here. And he just casually walks away. Is he gonna
die? He might die.
No.
Close. Just about. And I feel really sad for Jekyll right then. He only had 2 seconds left on his Omnistar. He could have killed off. Come with me then. Oh, and Cheshire Cat, cheeky with the rocket flare, but was unable to connect on Come With Me.
Now, at least at base, she gets her his desolator on her, so. Did the rock and lay in some real minus armor here. I'm just looking if somebody's gonna get a medallion.
I've seen TA go to medallion as well. Like, medallion's usually support item, but here we go now. Gore again, slapped by the zombie.
And Sunstrike on the mark. Shorts, oh! Push him out! Snowball is still there. Is it able to connect? No, it's not. There's gonna be the hookshot saving him. Now, Cheshire Cat is kind of alone because the fish still kills him off. Punch into the air, but with the blade mill, he's just pretty much signed his own death there. Well, Gyrocopter is able to get a kill there as well. Actually, 2-for-2 trade at the moment. Cover Me is going after Jekyll. He's trying to spin away from here, but there is the TA trap slowing down. Come with me. Rocket is on top of Jekyll, but I don't think they're gonna pursue this kill all the way through.
Yeah, he really needs level 11 before he starts committing the Omni Slash, and he realized that as well. And we have a pause coming out now from Cheshire Cat.
Nice servers, Dota 2. Some lags here for PR and Burden, but I'm not really experiencing any myself, and okay, they're gonna go and try it again. We might see a quick pause again if they keep on lagging here.
Yeah.
Before the cast is actually gonna ask it, we're playing on the Luxembourg server.
Mm.
Just so they know. And yeah, there's gonna be another break here. What do you think? How is all going right now? Are they able to win this game in a late game, or?
I've got 640 ping.
You do?
Yeah.
Hmm.
I've got 37% packet loss.
Well, let me check mine then.
I got 34 now.
I got 8 MS. I'm going strong, and they went another sick. They went someone went AFK, maybe take a piss, get a drink.
Yes, come with me.
And yeah, as the moment is going, PR there ahead with 5k gold at the moment. XP just 2.5. It's not the biggest lead at the moment, but it is a lead nonetheless. It's still turnable though for Burden. In terms of map control at the moment, PR has, of course, the upper hand here, having 2 towers destroyed already. Easy access to the Asians of the Radiant side here, Burden, as well as the jungle, is able to be accessed quite easily. With just the tier 1 left here on the bottom. Well, Nies just goes out of here. Well.
And we have a disconnect here. I've still got 34 MS, I'm doing okay. It's fluctuating a little bit. I'm getting 100 to 34. I'm usually like about 15.
We'll see. I'm really not experiencing anything, but that's just me.
Yeah, it's because you're special, Sander.
That's because I have 100 MBS.
That might be.
Okay, Nias is back. We're gonna go back into the match. Sorry for the break here. Little bit of server issues with Valve, but. Hopefully it's all fixed now in this game 3 of the show match organized by Esports Against Addictions.
Really good cause. Donate.
Do it now. Do it all
now.
The time.
They are a lot of support for especially people in server with educating about drugs and drug use as well. And they also buy books for Serbian children as well for local libraries and local schools. Yeah, donate to them. Really good cause.
Yeah, you can find them at esportsagainstaddictions.com. Just go to the website and give them some love there. While we go back into the show match game 3 here. Oh, Dirty Ross, he's come with me. They see each other. Oh, Shards keeps him away. Cheshire Cat hookshots in. Fine's going with me, but there is a snowball saving him. And they go after Dirty Raw right now. Put him in top in the air. Knees though, he gets an Omni Slash on top of him. Call down is used. Dirty Raw dies. They're turning him one around, but who's winning this coming with me? He's though, he's able to get out. There is going to be the totem used by Bignum. Oh, J Ford's on the good side here. They can only really go after other people right now. Oh, come with me. He runs into Cheshire Cat and just dies here.
Oh, Console Blast. Oh,
J4. He's kind of alone here. He might get it out from Rush. No, he won't. They get and kill him in 2v2.
Roshan's fed up of bullcrap in his home.
Oh, Naomi, he gets off the fissure here, and well, this means there will be no pursuit from PR here.
That's a 2v2 there. There was a position 4 Tusk and the position 1 come with me, and then Ditch RR taking a fall there, as well as the position 5 J4 Wyvern.
If we look at the fight recap, it's pretty even, just a little bit more for PR, 300 more XP and about 75 gold, so not that big of a change there. Biggest change will come from not being able to farm all this time on the gyrocopter.
Yeah, come with me, showing that he's very versatile. We've seen him on a few heroes, micro-intensive heroes like Enchantress, as well as the gyrocopter
and the tiny.
Yeah, he's been playing a great versatile, array of heroes.
They see the rush. They're kind of stuck here. There's going to be the cooldown use. Oh no, Jekyll was not able to get out. There's going to be the Walrus Punch putting him into the air. Jekyll is low, but Come With Me is also low. They're all just fighting it. They're all over the place. Cheshire Cat is still going strong here. Dirty Rod is able to kill off Roshan here, but Asian is denied by Mind Control. He just destroys it. And now Dirty Rod is low. He gets off the refraction here, but he's going man mode, but that's not going to be something that he's going to win here. Gorek, well, it's a 4-for-1 trade. It's still a victory for PR here, with also getting a rush. But still, it's a really, really messy fight here.
Yeah, the sigil just separated Ditch RR from getting the Aegis. And then the Forge Spirits just came in, and boom, the Aegis was denied. Ping in fight. What?
Don't ping in the fight.
I didn't ping.
I didn't do it either. I think it might be the... I don't know who did it. Doesn't matter. But did I do it? I actually don't know. Well, doesn't matter. Igor is stepping in everybody on their feet. Are they doing it? I don't know.
I don't know. I reckon it's a Chinese cast. It's a Chinese people.
Might be the our Humo casters, or it might just be Igor and comrades doing it. It doesn't really matter though. Yeah. It's cool. It gives another extra bit of tension there. Everything going crazy. Ooh. Rocket Flare hits my homie. He just starts running away. Still at the moment, Come With Me has been top of the leaderboards the entire game. They're not able to really get him out of there while he's building up towards his Sanjay and Yasha here.
I think that PR need to close this game sooner rather than later, because Gyrocopter, Invoker, and even Undying as well, they somewhat scale quite well. Undying, not so much.
I think Tusk is a better scaling hero than the Undying.
Yeah, but he's got nothing.
Yeah, that's the problem.
Got an urn. Like, that's absolutely nothing.
If you get like a Silver Edge on somebody, you can just disable the crit from Jugger.
Oh yeah, that would be really good. But TA,
as well
TA,
as the TA
does
stuff.
Drop off.
As well as the Psy Blade from TA though.
Like, Jackal is playing really well again. He's just farming and he's looking around the map. There's still a big stack here in on the Dire Ancients. They really need to take that.
As well as the Radiant Ancient is also a nice deck. And
Dirty
Rock comes in. He's just gonna go do some damage. There's gonna be the cooldown for Come With Me though, but he's not able to really do anything as the Omni Slash comes through. Jekyll is kind of in the enemy territory right now and tries to spin out from here. Well, the Tusk Shard just put away Cheshire Cat and brings Come With Me as well, as he is closer to the enemy. He just needs one more poke and he will get it. Dirty Rock gets another kill here. Well, Come With Me, he gets slowed by the trap. He's bottling up the best way he can, and oh, the melt strike on top of him. J4 also laying in a little bit of right clicks here, but Dirty Rush should be able to get this kill. Double kill for him. And now Jekyll, he's just going after the Ancients. He doesn't care about the kills. Just okay, they're just gonna get healed up. Five people from PR are still alive, while they're three down at the moment for Burden. They're not able to defend this tier two here in middle.
I think this is gonna take a fall right now. Microtron on this Invoker, I don't think, can do anything.
At the moment, he's just so shut down. And soon they're gonna be BKBs coming out. That
yeah.
should be the next purchase for Dirty Raw here after it. Since he got this blink. Oh, hookshot in! They find Mayumi in Chester Cat. Just hookshot them to know that, let them know, like, I'm here. You're not to be able to do anything. He's getting close to his blink though, but still, it's still about 700 gold off. It's close, but not close enough, and he still needs another 5 minutes.
In the yeah, here we going. Go with, here we go with Jackal. What do you think he'll be picking up next? I reckon he might get the casual Yasha.
Yasha, we might just start building up for Scotty here. You know, get some stats, get tanky, make sure that he can survive through all of it, and yeah, at the moment, Might Control Invoker is really strong, but you know, just having his Midas as well as
Aghanim's
Step of Wizard is just...
Korek has Aghanim's Cottle.
Oh man, that's pretty big.
Yeah, that's he's pulling all his teammates around the map now, and just looking for a push button.
Yeah, this is going to utilize his recall to the fullest. As well as... No one during daytime, man, you're not gonna do anything. You're just gonna see your Mind Control. He just gets hookshot here by Cheshire Cat. He just go in Fizz, but they have a dust ready on J4. Mind Control, yeah. Oh, he gets pushed out by the shards here, but it doesn't really matter. He will still die.
Dichara, he's literally just cleaning up the towers like he's been cleaning up Burn United. And yeah. Here we go, Jackal pushing in now. I think that Niz gonna give a good defense here. There's Echo Slam up, but there's no Blink Dagger, not for another 200 gold on the Earthshaker. And
they just need it, and he doesn't even have a TP either. Oh, come with me. Oh, they're just TPing everybody on top of him. Cheshire Cat, he needs to get in range for a hookshot or maybe something else. But oh, come with me, he's just too fast, and he even gets Glimmer K there.
Oh, no, the chase trap. Not Ooh. So long left now on the hookshot. He's turning around, he's baiting them up.
Bidwise walking around them.
Gonna be clutch.
Oh, I'm lagging up pretty heavily actually right now. Okay, it stops. And yeah, the teams are actually also getting lagged. Okay, I'm back to 38 right now.
Yeah.
And yeah. They're just gonna wait out this lag spike coming from the servers. And okay. I'm all good again. Okay, players are also all good. We're gonna go in again. Well, there's gonna be a rocket flying. Who's it gonna go after? It's gonna go after Cheshire Cat. Are they gonna go in this? No.
Yeah, here we go now. I've stopped lagging. That
Plus
was
the players,
horrible.
And they just disengage ordinarily on both sides. Not really willing to go for anything else. While the Sigil is still flying, going for a little trip around the world.
Yeah, I think that PR just gonna insert right now and just go straight for this tier 2 top.
Yeah, no reason for them to really stop right now. Mind Control is not in space, in place to defend. This, oh, it's actually gonna hit him, the homing missile. Oh, there is the homing slash, but it's gonna use the Glimmer Cave there to keep Con with me alive. And they start gonna doing some damage in the tower here.
Yeah, this just kicks. Become daytime right now, so Cottle can just spam out that Illuminate, just keep healing everybody up and doing damage to the enemy creep wave.
As well as the big vision range from it.
Oh, and the big vision, yeah, that's something you shouldn't underestimate. Keep
You're
up
not gonna
the light.
Hide here.
It's so good in daytime with Aghanim Scepter.
Just think about it, if you have a Night Stalker and an. As well as the Keeper of the Light with both with an Aghanim, like, you have always vision everywhere. It's so ridiculous.
Yeah.
Though it's quite hard to. To achieve, it's still 4,200 golds on both. The Sigil gets destroyed, and 110 golds going the way of Gorek here.
I think that PR have all realised that they need to finish this quick. They don't want to take this late game. And on the top lane, there's three people up here, but Gorek can recall them. Like, Jackal can be doing his own thing, and right now, look, Cheshire Cat's doing his own thing. It's just amazing what the Cottle can do.
There's a cooldown, yeah, 60 second cooldown on a recall though, so that's a little bit of a waiting time between both, so...
15 seconds.
Yeah, 15? I thought 16. It's 16.
On the ultimate, but 15 on the
recall.
Recall.
16.
Yeah, 15.
16. Recall, check it. Click on it, you go over it.
15.
It's really 15. 16, dude. Oh, blind. Shit, I'm looking at blinding light. What's wrong with me? Sorry about that. Oh my god, that's a big fail there for
that's
me.
That's 1-0 to me, everybody.
Oh man. Well, it's just 1 second difference. We're just gonna forget it. I'm gonna forget it. Well, they're still just hanging around on top, but really not committing that much. While Jekyll is just pushing out bot here. Treasure Cat is coming back to his team now. Well, the four spears are being farmed up. His shards are pretty nice here. Dirty Wild is kind of stuck.
Yeah.
They're not able to go on him.
Big hook shot from downtown.
But yeah, he found Miomi here in the forest. There's going to be the snowball. Now they're fighting two versus him. While Jekyll gets off the Omni Slash. It's just hitting the Necro Keep mostly right now. And still no deaths at the moment. Oh, Winter's Curse on Nihis. Miomi is still alive. And Jekyll, they're trying to get out of here. PR, that is. But Koumi, he walks in. Gorik taking a lot of damage. He's going to die here. Mind control low. But they're not able to kill him off right now. He's still alive. J4 taking a lot of damage. He's gonna take a fall. 2 for 2. Big Num. He's dead.
Town.
Well, now come with me. He's gonna get followed. Oh, Cheshire get beautiful four step into a Cox. But is it gonna be his own death? Yes, it is. But they are able to still clean.
Triple kill for Dichara. And I believe that the tier 2 will be going down on the top lane right now.
Yeah, Jekyll. He can just start pushing it in.
Yeah, Jekyll's an African dog, right?
Hmm? A Jekyll. It's an African kind of dog, yes.
Yeah, yeah.
Very aggressive, lives in packs. Kind of like vultures, you know, they eat deaf animals.
Sorry to interrupt this cast. Sander's going on to a environmental cast sort of thing.
Yeah, I've been in Africa, I've seen them.
Oh, sorry, Mr. Sander.
Dennis now, and well, actually, Dirty Wild, he's gonna get a snowball. Nope, Link in town. Well, there's a nice regeneration room waiting for him. Refill is already full bottle.
Yeah.
Oh, they did actually lose the courier with the Mentor Stealth for Jekyll.
Oh, and the Roshan's up in a few seconds, and there's 5k gold on Dichara.
Yeah, and he's also looking at the triple stack here. I was about to say a dirty stack here, but Sunstrike, yeah, it's gonna scout out that there's no one in rush right now.
No, and Roshan's gonna be up in the next minute. Not even that, 10
minute,
seconds.
10 seconds. And well.
And there we go, Roshan will be up. The big man has respawned.
What do you think Dirty Wild's going for? I think he's gonna go BKB.
But if BKB, yeah. I totally
you, no,
agree.
You want to say Butterfly.
I was gonna say Butterfly, but no, I thought you already had one.
Well, he's farmed, but not that farmed. Well, Clockwork, he has his Sanjay ready as well, ready to rock here. Oh, Burden, they're trying to go for the rush here, but they're just lining up really, really nicely as well for Winter's Curse. Come with me, gets on top of him. Spit the best is used, and there's going to be a hook shot in the back as well. They fight Miomi, they kill him off. Knees is getting low right now. Jekyll just spinning around, there's going to be the snowball. Jekyll, oh, he just gets off.
He
only says in a nick of time. And Dirty Wild, he got his BKB delivered here. Well, Knees, oh, he's just going to get blown up here. Dirty Wild's trying to clean it up. He's just gonna get Bolt Embrace here to keep him alive a little bit longer. While Kobe Bean's trying to do a bit more damage. Oh, Dirty Wild's just alive. Oh, he just lived through all of that. Really, really low. To get a kill on Kobe Bean and Big Num. Oh, yeah, he's gonna die here. Oh, well, Cheshire Cat, he gets. Okay, let's look at Cheshire Cat.
And then there we go. He just cleans up the Roshan.
It's a 1-for-4 trade plus rush. Dirty Wild, he is a happy, happy man. He got his BKB and now another 3.8k gold.
Yeah, so he's gonna get that butterfly now.
He might.
He
or
will.
He might just build up towards a Daedalus here.
A Daedalus is a good shout here, but he's just a bit squishy and the butterfly gives him that more survivability. Especially against the Tusk, the Invoker, Forge Spirits, and himself and the Gyrocopter. The
Gyrocopter though might be building up towards an MKB. But that's like a pretty natural build up for him, so that's the only downside for getting a butterfly here. He doesn't,
yeah.
He isn't close to it though, it's just something that might be in the future. But we'll see, it has 4.1k, and yes, it's gonna be the Daedalus. At least I still know the item builds.
I think PR are gonna look to finish it off now. All the big ultimates are coming off cooldown, there's only 20 seconds left on the Omni Slash, and Winter's Curse has just come off cooldown.
Well, Mind Control, he is going for the Zoo build. He has his Necro Boots. Necrobrook in level 2 here. Not level 3 just yet, so. Well, PR are settling up to start pushing in bot here. Might want to get Cheshire Cat first now. I just leave the other recall for Jekyll, so we can just farm a little bit more. Yeah, Mycator is going to get out of here. Actually, maybe looking for something in top here, if they actually keep on pushing him with Cheshire Cat, though. Jekyll is behind him, and probably me is pushing in the mid-tier 1 here. Trying to get some more gold, a little bit more map control. Jekyll blinks forward. Naomi, they see him. Do you want to go for him? No. He's kind of alone, so that would be a bad choice. Oh, what? He sees him. He needs to get out from here, well, because Come With Me is walking in. Yeah, he blinks back to his own tier 1.
Yeah. I think the Blink Dagger is a really good purchase on J4. Does PR need to close this? They need to finish this. Now.
There's going
to
be another BKB on the...
Come With Me. Well, Come With Me has his BKB, but yeah, Jack just picked one.
But Naomi, he's found Hookshot on top of him. There's going to be the Snowball, though, saving him. Now, Cheshire Cat is kind of alone here. Well, Jekyll actually gets off a nice Omni Slash here. On top of Come With Me, well, Cheshire Cat is able to get down to low ground here. He has.
Cheshire has his Daedalus now.
Now, they're just going to destroy this Stodem here. Well, Bird and United are in full retrieve. The drop blinks forward, finds Knees, kills him off.
Yeah, there's a buyback up on the Gyrocopter if needed, and I think it's going to be needed right now because PR looking very strong now, just going up on the high ground. Hopefully, Burden United can defend. Like, I'm sure that Mind Control can pull off a few combos here.
Nice fishy there, keep making sure that Jekyll can't hit the tower, but still Dirty Rock can apply a lot of minus armor and damage to it.
Yeah, there's 2 minutes left on the Aegis right now.
And Burden, they're just trying to keep them all out of the base here. It did just turn daylight as well, so the Cuttle is also very happy.
That crit. Here we go now. PR are looking to push high ground. Okay, the
still
cooldown's
have the Aegis. How long do they have it?
They
still
have it for another minute and a half.
2.5 minutes.
Minute and a half. Bitch.
Minute and a half, yes. But yeah, they just send Jekyll top. And start farming up the enemy jungle for now. They don't seem too willing to end it right now. Or Lidnos rushed. What is actually at the moment, man? They're ahead. 25 gold. 25k gold it is, of course, for PR that's at the moment. And over 30k experience here. Man, that's just the utilization of...
Of the Cottle, I think. Yeah. I think the Cottle was great and playing outstandingly.
Yeah, just having the recall there. Just make sure that you can farm the entire map at all times. Well, J4 sees Bignum. Ooh. Burden, they're far out of their comfort zone, out of their base. Bignum, he just gets blown up by Dirty Raw. Cauldron is going to be there. It doesn't hit Dirty Raw here. There's going to be the Snowball. He's going to go after Dirty Raw. And there we go. But yeah, he's against Dirty Raw.
Oh my.
Ouch.
One shot him.
That's a dead Tusk.
That's a dead Tusk.
I didn't. Yeah. I don't think Dirty Raw knows that. I think polar bears are in the endangered species list, aren't they?
Yeah.
I think he didn't receive the notification of that one, as he just blows him up.
Dirty Raw is sponsoring no pandas today.
No, polar bear is dead here. And another nice zoning fissure, but it doesn't keep out Dirty Raw from hitting this tower. And the sharks put him even closer. That's kind of awkward as it is. As he just lays down the damage. Oh, there's going to be Snowball put into the air. He still has the Aegis for some time here. So even if he dies, he's just okay. But he will survive through it. Well, Jekyll gets off the Omni Slash here in the back lines. Killing off not one, but two people. Now Naomi, he is going to get Winter's Curse damage. He gets off a nice Echo Slam here. But he's not able to kill off Dirty Raw. He's still alive. Bignum, GG calls.
GG.
And PR winning the game. Burden United put up a really good fight. Like, Burden United, I expected 2-0 PR, but Burn United, they really surprised me and they played really well.
Yeah, it was so fun to see the first main game, especially just the IO carrying getting kills. It was so good to see. As well as in the second game, seeing PR with, you know, the dropping the mechanism just to try and get them off hitting the Rex there. Didn't work. Show match here for 500 gold is won by PR in a 2-1 versus Burden United, and well, This, I think they're gonna have more show matches here. They're all gonna be organized by Esports Against Addictions, a great cause, guys. Just follow them, donate them, help them out. Raising awareness about drugs and all those kind of things. So yeah, man, just really follow it. This was a great best of three. I really, really enjoyed it.
I loved it too.
Yeah, Zach and George as well. We're the casters from a Swiss Dota community. I am Sander. With me was Zach. Well, guys, I hope you all enjoyed it. And hope to see you soon with other tournaments as well.
Okay, thank you very much. Bye, guys. See you later.